Hi friends, now we shall discuss about Maxwell's curl equation for a static electric field. Okay, already we have gotten a conservative field equation, that is our closed surface integral over E dot dl will be equal to 0. That is nothing but the potential difference for a closed surface will be 0 since its initial and final points are same. Hence the potential difference between the starting and ending points will be definitely 0. That means for a closed surface the potential difference will be 0. And that is equals to closed surface integral of E dot dl, that will be equals to 0. Okay, here in order to explain that, we are considering two points A and B in the field produced by the charge Q, by a point charge Q. This is the electric field produced by the point charge Q. Okay, and this is the closed surface which we are considering in this electric field. Okay, it starts from A to B. Okay, it's a closed path. As if you observe the curves, you can easily observe it. It's a closed path. So, for this, the potential difference between A and B, VAB will be definitely equals to minus VBA. Okay. Or VBA will be equals to minus VAB. Okay. Thereby, if this RHS side is brought to LHS side, means it becomes positive. And here nothing will remain. That means here it will be 0. Okay. VBA plus VAB will be equals to 0. And we know that the potential is equals to closed surface integral of E dot dl from the definition of it as well as the formula. Okay. Therefore, closed surface integral over E dot dl is equals to 0. Okay. And for any field which is obeying this conservative, nothing but it's a conservative in nature. Hence, if any field follows this conservative nature, means it comes under a conservative field. Okay? And it obeys conservative property also. Already we have discussed about the conservative property. Okay? And conservative field. Okay? This is one of it. This shows that the line integral of E bar along a closed path as shown in PPT has to be 0. Okay? Physically, this implies that no work is done in moving a charge along a closed path. Okay? If we are going to move a charged particle along a closed particle, means it implies that there is no work at all. Okay, it is for that too in an electrostatic field. Remember this, that too it is in an electrostatic field. If it comes under time varying, means this is entirely opposite for that. It won't be equal to 0. It will have some value. Okay, and this can be referred from these. With the help of this Stokes theorem, we can derive a small expression of Maxwell's equation. Okay, with the help of this Stokes theorem, we can easily derive one of the Maxwell's equations in point form. Okay, that is, the Stokes theorem states that the surface integral of the curl of a vector field A bar taken over any surface S is equals to the line integral of A bar around the closed periphery of the surface. Okay, I am repeating it again. The surface integral of the curl of a vector field. Curl of a vector means del cross. Okay, the curl of a vector field taken over any surface. For any surface. Okay, what it might be the shape of it. If we consider over any surface S, yes, it will be definitely equals to the line integral of a vector around the closed periphery. It must be a closed periphery. It's a closed contour of the boundary of the surface. Okay, and symbolically for an any vector field, we can represent it in as integral over C closed. The circle of over an integral represents closed. Okay, this is the contour. Okay, over C is the closed contour of the bounding surface. Okay, and this is the vector A bar. It's a vector field. The closed contour over A bar dot dl bar will be equals to surface integral over the curl of a vector. This represents curl of a vector. Del cross is represents a curl of a vector. Which is the that's where C is the closed contour bounding the surface S. Okay. From Stokes theorem, here we are considering the electric field as E bar, electric field intensity. Okay. So, hence, by applying Stokes theorem, the closed surface integral over E dot dl bar will be equals to the surface integral over curl of the E bar. Curl is nothing but del cross E bar. dot ds bar. Already we know that the closure integral over the E dot dl is equals to 0. Thereby, as E bar dot dl bar is equals to surface integral over the curl of E bar, thereby the curl of E bar will be equals to 0. Okay? Curl is nothing but del cross. Del cross E bar is equals to 0. So, any vector field that satisfies these equations, either closed surface integral over E bar dot dl bar equal to 0 or del bar cross E bar is equals to 0. Any of these two is gone satisfied means it comes and it's said to be irrotational as well as conservative. Okay. And thus, an electrostatic field is a conservative field. And these equations refers to the Maxwell's equations for static electric fields. One is in the integral form as well as equation 1 is in integral form and equation 2 is the differential form or point form. Okay. Coming to this Poisson's and Laplace equations, obtaining Poisson's equation is extremely simple from the point form of Gauss law. What is the point form of Gauss law? Actually, what the Gauss law states? The Gauss law states that whenever the electric flux passing through any closed surface is equals to the charge enclosed by the surface. And from that, we have derived the Gauss law in point form of as del dot B is equals to rho V. Okay. This from the definition of D, we already know that D is equals to epsilon. And the gradient relation E is equals to minus W. By using all these things, by substitution, del dot in place of D, we are substituting epsilon E and E is equals to minus del V. Okay, we have substituted all this. And these are all equals to rho V from the Gauss law. Okay. And therefore, if we take this epsilon to RHS side, it will come to denominator. And by taking this minus sign to RHS side, and then finally on RHS side, what it remains? Del dot del V. That is nothing but del square V. Okay? Del square V is equals to minus rho V by epsilon. This is nothing but the Poisson's equation. Okay? This equation is called Poisson's equation. But the double Bell operation must be interpreted and expanded. Okay? At least in Cartesian. Okay. So we are expressing it, this expression in Cartesian coordinates x, y, z. Thereby, we are using this for del dot A means it will be, for example, if it is del dot A means dou AX by dou X plus dou AY by dou Y plus dou AZ. Thereby, if we in order to get this del square V expression, how it will be in a Cartesian coordinate system, we are trying to do that. And we know the idea of del dot A. That means if we apply del operation to a scalar, it will convert it into vector. Okay. Now, here potential is the scalar component. Thereby, we are applying del. How the del will be dou by dou x of that particular scalar component A in x coordinate, as well as dou by dou y of AY. In place of A, here our potential will be there. Okay. And this is the del V expression. Dou V by dou X AX bar plus dou V by dou Y AY bar plus dou V by dou Z AZ bar. Okay. But our aim is to find out the del square V expression. Del square V. So, we have to apply del to this del V. Then, we will get the del square V. Hence, we are applying del dot del V. Okay, we are doing dot product with del. Then, it can be converted into del square. Since, the angle between these two will be 0, thereby cos 0 will be equals to 1. And applying del means nothing but dou by dou x ax plus dou by dou y ay plus dou by dou z az. And we know the del V expression. So, by doing dot product of these two, it will be dou by dou x of dou V by dou x plus dou by dou y of dou V by dou y plus dou by dou z of dou V by dou z. Hence, it will be dou square V by dou x square plus dou square V by dou y square plus dou square V by dou z square. And usually, the operation del dot del is nothing but del square. Hence, on a LHS side, it will be del square V. Therefore, in Cartesian coordinate system, the del square V is equals to dou square V by dou X square, dou square V by dou Y square, plus dou square V by dou Z square. Okay? And we know that Poisson's equation, del square V is equals to minus rho V by epsilon. It's clear. So, for an insulating body, for a dielectric material, what about this del square V? For a dielectric medium, is there will be any free charges available over the surface? There will be no charge. If there is no charge, then rho V will be equals to, since rho V is equals to that charge per unit volume. If there is no charge per volume, per unit volume or for the entire volume, if we consider it as rho V, then rho V will becomes zero. So, then del square V will be equals to zero. I think you got my point. I am repeating it again. If rho V is equals to zero, what it means? Rho V is equals to zero. It indicating zero volume charge density. So, for a charge free space, nothing but we are considering a material where there is no charge, nothing but insulator. So, for an insulator or for a dielectric medium, as there are no free charges, that definitely rho V will become zero. That is nothing but del square V is equals to zero, which is nothing but the Laplace's equation. Okay. Hence, the del square operation of V is called Laplacian of V. Okay. Now, in Cartesian coordinates, the Laplace equation is considered as, already we have derived for del square V in Cartesian coordinates. That is, del square V by dou x square plus del square V by dou y square plus del square V by dou z square. And that will be equals to 0, since it is a Laplace equation. Okay, which we have derived earlier. So, in cylindrical coordinate system, what are the coordinates in cylindrical coordinate system? Where rho is the radius of the cylinder, and pi is the angle with respect to x-axis, and z is the length of your cylinder. Hence, del square V is equals to 1 by rho dou by dou rho dou V by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square V by dou pi square plus dou square V by dou z square. This is the cylindrical coordinate system Laplace equation. And in spherical coordinate system, the Laplace equation is del square V is equals to 1 by r square dou by dou r square dou V by dou r plus 1 by r square sin theta dou by dou theta sin theta dou V by dou theta plus 1 by r square sin square theta dou square V by dou phi square. And these are the things which we have to keep in your mind, because they may ask a question as to explain about Laplace and Poisson's equation and express them in all the three coordinates. Then you have to write these three equations also. You doesn't need to derive this, just you have to write these expressions and you have to write the solution for these equations in the three coordinates. Okay, so we are going to discuss about the solution of Laplace equation. So, firstly, in rectangular form, the solution of Laplace equation in rectangular coordinates. Rectangular coordinates are nothing but x, y, z, okay? So, in order to find out the solution, we are considering a parallel plate capacitor, okay? Let us consider a parallel plate capacitor with one plate kept at x equal to 0 and the other plate is kept at x equal to d. As if you see this picture, you will get an idea. This is the parallel plate capacitor, okay? Here is the place where x equals to 0 and d is the distance between them, and here is the place where x equal to d. So here is the potential where V is equals to 0 and here is the potential where V is equals to V naught. That means at x equal to 0, V will be 0 on this plate on negative charge, where x, since there is we are considering as x equal to 0, and here is the positive charge where we are considering at x equal to d. Since here the distance is of 0 and here the distance is of d. Okay. And here the potential will be V is equals to V naught. We have to use these limits. That's why we are focusing on it. Okay. X varies from 0 to d and V varies from 0 to V naught. Okay. So, the left plate is at zero potential and that of the right plate is at the potential V naught. And we will use this Laplace equation to calculate the potential distribution between these two plates. We are going to use the Laplace equation to calculate the potential distribution between these two plates. Okay. Since there is no variation along Y or Z axis, as if you observe, this is along X axis. The difference is varying along x-axis. It is at the origin position and it is at the position where it is x equal to d. Okay, and there is no variation about a y or z axis here. There is nothing variation along y or z axis. Okay, it is purely varying only on x axis. Hence, remaining terms becomes constant and the differentiation becomes zero. Only x axis differentiation will remain, and that too it varies continuously. Hence, there will be a constant for an integration of a zero. Okay, its partial derivative is also replaced by ordinary derivative, as v is not a function of y and z, and thereby on integration we get the integral d square v by dx square is equals to integral over zero, and integration of a zero will also becomes a constant since it is a continuous function. Okay, so for any integration, integral over dv by dx is equals to integral over a. Since integral of zero, we are considering a constant as a. Okay, and again we are integrating the expression. Thereafter, we can remove this differentiation. Hence, integral over dv is equals to integral over a. This dx on LHS will be moved to RHS, and which will become as numerator. And thereafter, integral over dv will be equals to integral over a dx. So, a is a constant. Hence, we will keep it out. Integral over dx is nothing but x, and again, it's a continuous expression. Hence, it will become some plus some constant b. Okay. Thereby, v is equals to ax plus b. And this is the solution of Laplace equation. And now, we will apply the initial and final conditions in order to find out these constants a and b. So, at x equal to 0, the v will be equals to 0. Thereby, b becomes 0. Okay, at x equal to 0, v is equals to 0. By substituting those two, then b becomes 0. Then expression will be v is equals to x. Now, if we consider the final limits, x equal to d and v is equals to v naught, if we substitute them, then v naught becomes ad. Thereby, a is equals to v naught by d. Okay, as b is equals to 0, we got the value of b, a equal to v naught by b. And now, substituting both a and b values in the initial expression which we have got, b is equals to ax plus b. Now, so, by substituting a value and b value, finally the expression is v is equals to v naught by d of x. This is the potential distributed between the plates which we have obtained by using the Laplace equation. With the help of Laplace equation, we have found out the potential distribution between the two parallel plates. Clear? Okay. And this is the potential inside the capacitor. And potential at any point can be obtained by substituting the corresponding value of distance. Okay. We have to substitute the value of distance. Then only we will get the corresponding value of potential. Okay. And next solution to the Laplace equation in cylindrical coordinates. What are the cylindrical coordinates? Rho, phi and z. I have initially said that rho is nothing but the radius of your cylinder and y is the angle with respect to x-axis of its axis, and z is the length of the cylinder. So, we are considering a cylindrical capacitor. Okay. We are considering a cylindrical capacitor. So, this is the inner view, as this is the external one, and the inner it is having a radius of a, and external it is having a radius of v, and that is the length of your cylinder, where rho is the radius which is varying from a to b. Okay, rho component is only varying, remaining phi and z, nothing but the length of the cylinder and the angles with respect to the coordinate is also not varying, only rho is varying. Okay, keep this in mind. The external cylinders, external nothing but outer part is connected to the ground, which is having a potential v is equals to 0, and here is the potential will be v naught. Okay, so let us find the solution and then apply the conditions, thereby you will get the final equation. Okay, this is the cylindrical coordinate system Laplacian equation. Del square v is equals to 1 by rho dou by dou rho of rho dou v by dou rho plus 1 by rho square dou square v by dou phi square plus rho square v by dou z square, and this will be equals to 0 since it is a Laplacian equation. And we are considering a cylindrical capacitor which is having an inner radius of a and external radius of b, and it is run that variation of field is only with respect to rho and not with respect to phi or z. It is running. That variation of the field is only due to rho. Keep this in mind. Only the radius is going to vary. Remaining other two are constant. Hence, the first term will remain. Remaining other two will become zero. That means here, the first term will be available. Since the differentiation of a constant here, it becomes zero. Here also it becomes zero. Since the field is not varying with respect to these two, so these two terms become zero. Only it is varying with respect to rho. Hence, this will only remain, and this will be equated to 0 since del square is equals to 0. So, after equating, this rho will move to RHSR and hence it will vanish. Only the expression of dou by dou rho of rho dou v by dou rho is equals to 0 will remain. So, by applying integration on both sides, now the expression will be rho dou v by dou rho will be equals to integral of 0 is nothing but A. And thereafter, dou v by dou rho, if we move this rho onto the RHS side, then it comes to denominator, thereby A by rho. So integral over dv is equals to A integral over 1 by rho d rho, and 1 by rho is nothing but log, ln of rho. So A ln rho plus, since it's a continuous function, it's represented with a constant of b. This is the solution we have obtained. Now, in order to find out the constants A and B, we are applying initial and final conditions. That means at rho is equal to A and rho equal to B. What is the potential at rho equal to A? At inner rho, it is having a potential of V naught, and external, it is having a potential of 0. Since the external body is connected to ground. So, when rho is equal to B, the external radius, external body is connected, V is equals to 0. By substituting that, the expression will be 0 is equals to A ln rho plus B. In place of rho, we have to substitute B, as we have considered rho is equals to B. Thereby B is equals to, here it is positive, by moving to RHS it becomes negative. Hence B is equals to minus A ln B. Substituting B in V is equals to A ln rho plus B, then it becomes A ln of log A minus log B. What it means? Formula, logarithmic formula, log A by B. So in the same manner, ln of rho minus ln of B. What it means? Ln rho by B. So now, when rho is equals to A and V is equals to V naught, V naught becomes A ln of A minus A ln of B. Hence, V naught is equals to A ln of A by B. So this is the A value. A is equals to V naught ln B by A. And now we are substituting A is equals to V naught ln of B by A in initial expression. V is equals to A ln of rho by B. Then V becomes V naught of ln B by A. We are substituting A value over here. Then V naught, came to the LHSR, it comes to denominator, and the things remained are ln of b by ln of a. What it means? Log of b by a is nothing but log b by log a. In the same manner, ln of b by ln of a, ln of rho by ln of b. Ln of b gets cancelled off, only ln of rho by ln of a will remain. Thereby v is equals to v naught ln of rho by a. This is the potential distribution in a cylindrical capacitor. And coming to the solution of Laplace equation in spherical coordinate system. For that, we are considering spherical capacitors. So, we are considering the spherical capacitor of radius A and B, which are placed concentrically. Let the potential of the inner sphere be V naught. This is the inner sphere and this is the external sphere or outer sphere, which is connected to the ground. Hence, its potential is zero. The outer sphere, which is having a potential V is equals to 0 and having the radius of B. And inner sphere, it is having a potential of V naught, which is having a radius of A. This is the main part between these two. Thereby, the del square V expression for the spherical coordinate system already we have discussed, that is 1 by r square dou by dou r of r square dou v by dou r plus 1 by r square sin theta dou by dou theta sin theta dou v by dou theta plus 1 by r square sin square theta dou square v by dou phi square, which is equals to 0, since it is a Laplacian equation. So, considering the variation is along only radius of the sphere, nothing but r, or if you consider it as row, no problem. Based on the term which you have indicated, you have to write it. Okay, here we are considering the sphere of the radius as R, okay, which is varying between A and B. Hence, you can observe the variation is only along the radius of the sphere, and remaining other two terms will be considered as constant. Hence, the first term will remain and the remaining other two are zero. Hence, the expression is 1 by r square dou by dou r of r square dou v by dou r is equals to 0. Okay, and if this r is r square moves to if this r square moves to RHSL, it becomes 0. Hence, that is dou by dou r of r square dou v by dou r is equals to 0. Now, by we can replace this partial differentiation with the normal derivative, ordinary derivative, since it's not a function of theta as well as phi, and thereby, by integrating on both sides, since it's a continuous function, the r square dou v by dou r will be equals to constant a. By integrating this expression, r square dv by dr will be equals to a, and if this r square moves to RHS side, it becomes 1 by r square, and dv is equals to a by r square dr. By integrating on both sides again, 1 by r square is nothing but r power minus 2, integral of r power minus 2. What it will become? R power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. Hence, minus 1 will be there in the denominator, and r power minus 1. We can write that as minus 1 by r. Okay? Hence, it is v is equals to minus a by r plus b. To evaluate the constants, we have to apply the limits or the values at r equal to b. V is equals to 0. By substituting that, capital B becomes capital A by B, small b. Okay. Thereby, the expression is V is equals to minus A by R plus capital B. We can substitute the value B is equals to A by small b. Okay. Then, it will be V is equals to minus A by small r plus capital A by B. Thereby, V is equals to, if you take this A common, it will be 1 by b minus 1 by r. Now, at v is equals to v naught, at r equal to a, v naught is equals to capital A of 1 by b minus 1 by a. And if we consider this expression as constant k, that is nothing but 1 by b minus 1 by a as k, then v naught will be equals to a into k. Therefore, a is equals to v naught by k. Substituting a is equals to v naught by k, v will be equals to v naught by k 1 by b minus 1 by r, and this is the potential inside the sphere. Okay, with the help of Laplace equation, we have determined the potential distribution inside the sphere. V is equals to V naught by k of 1 by b minus 1 by r. Okay, thank you.